If you don't succeed in this country, the fault is on you, not the white people, not the government, not anybody. You, the individual, you got to help yourself. I knew someday if I got a chance to come to America, I'll be successful. And thank God, 1977, I met an American who helped me to get an American visa. And I arrived in this country February 5th, 1978, with $100 in my pocket. My name is Stephen Osei. I love America, that's the title of my book, and I've lived the American dream. The United States gave us so much. So I told my son, the country has given you opportunity and a chance to be successful in life. So why don't you serve the country as a kind of payback? Without America, where would I be? Without America, where would you be? In Ghana, I couldn't have probably sent you to university, I couldn't. But because of the opportunities that are here, and they've given you a chance to be successful, you also go back and serve them. He said, which one do you study? I said, join the Marines, those are the tough guys. And he did for 12 years. The first 7 years, I was here by myself. All I did was to work 8 hours at night, 8 hours daytime. No car, no girlfriend. All I did was to save money. I strongly believe that there are some people who believe that they've been forced not to study. They've been forced to fail. And I don't believe that. Look at this country, freedom is everywhere. Good schools, good teachers. Everything is possible in this country compared to other countries. There are no freedoms. You say something against the government, you end up in jail. Ghana is a common practice. I live in a village with my father who didn't go to school, my mom, no school. Our village, there was no electricity, no running water. That's how I grew up. I got my first shoe at age 12 when my brother picked me from the village. By staying with my brother, I was able to go to school. Went to elementary school, went to secondary school, then I went to Wesley College. And at that time, President Kennedy was in charge. And three of my teachers were Americans who were in the Peace Corps. So I had an idea about opportunities that were in this country compared to other countries. People come here to better their lives. They see opportunities in this country. So many opportunities for their children. That's why they want to come here. Can Republicans and Democrats work together and solve the issue? So if I were to give Congress advice, I'd say, look here, give the president, he say, $5 billion to build a wall, whatever he wants. And let those DACA students stay here. Let them become citizens of this country. They are well educated. Some are serving the military. Why do you want to send these people back? What are they going to do? I have a wife, 4 kids, 7 grandkids, and one is on the way. 3 of my kids are brought from Ghana. All of them finished university. They all finished their masters. So all my 3 kids are very successful. So I'm very grateful to this great country. So the fact that you are born poor doesn't mean you should grow up to be poor. You don't have to. Look at my story, read my book, and you will see step-by-step-by-step approach to being successful in life. Stay in school, study hard, listen to your teachers, avoid bad groups. And I give thanks to God that I made it from that humble beginning all the way to owning a Mercedes. Something I never dreamt I could have done in Ghana, never. Opportunities are here. That's why I'm proud to be an American citizen, and I'm happy to be here. My name is Stephen Osei. I love America, and I've lived the American dream.